So today we're going to go through the first steps of building a Mazdaspeed motor. I've got a lot of questions and people ask me constantly what to do, what procedures to take, so we're going to go through a little bit of that. Hopefully today I'll be installing the crank, maybe the rods, pistons, but a little bit of backstory on this motor. We're going to go through a full top to bottom build. This motor had some oiling issues a few months ago, spun all the rod bearings. Not good. So as you can see here, we have a little warm, hot bearings. Bearings are roached. The crank was roached, so we got a new crank. We keyed the crank, because if you have a Mazdaspeed motor, you know that there are friction washers that hold the crank together, the gears onto the crank. So we keyed it for extra horsepower capabilities, because flimsy little paper washers are a little unsettling, even though I've seen them go 500 horsepower maybe. I can't be certain on that, but so like I said, we're going to go through that. Some essentials to start out with. Very key. Going to need some gloves. You're going to need some 30 weight oil. I put it in this jug because I can stick my brush in it, and so I can paint it on. Some alcohol. And I have ARP lube for when we do the head studs and main studs. And then Manly, because we are assembling the motor with Manly rods. Manly sells, or they give you that lube with the 625 bolts. And especially rags. You're gonna be careful with the rags because you don't want lint. Those are not lint free rags, but what are you gonna do? Just be careful. Anyways, we're gonna start with prepping the block and installing the bearings. In another video, I will go through what rod and piston combinations I recommend and what other people recommend and what they're capable of and what bolts you should go with and all of that stuff. That will be in a different video. It's already 8 o'clock. I want to be home before midnight. Okay, so first things first, right side up, and flip it over so we get to the bottom. Flip it upside down. Flip it upside down. And inside, you can see we have some oil squirters. Those are already in there. There's a process of bending them if we need to run Wisco pistons, because like I say all the time, Wisco made pistons for our cars, Manly designed pistons for our cars. So I generally like Manly's, but Wisco's work, they're still pistons, they still have rings, they still hold compression. It's just, I think it's a little ass and I need to bend the oil squirters, so Manly has a little notch in it, so you don't have to bend the oil squirters. So what we're gonna do first, we're gonna get our bearings, Mazda bearings, OEM. I particularly like them because there are no benefits of running aftermarket bearings, really. The reason I like Mazda bearings is because they were designed to last 200,000 miles, or whatever the manufacturer says. So I like those, you know, because they should last longer. I don't know. It's just a weird thing of mine, but I like them. So you've already, we can see that we have two different boxes came. So these are actually your main bearings. This is called your thrust bearing, thrust washer, whatever you want to call it. I'll describe that once, what this does once it is inside with the crank installed. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to open these guys up. Oh, those on there. So this moves. You can hear these move. They are bent in such a way and installed in such a way that they will not come out on their own. You'll have to force them out. Don't force them out. You don't need to. Leave them there. garbage. So then you notice two different types of bearings. We have a top bearing, so the block side, and then we have the girdle side. So there's reasons this looks like this is so oil can travel through this cutout here, this galley, whatever you want to call it, journal. And these holes, no matter which way I put it, it'll line up with the oil port on the block. So then you notice we have an odd number. We don't have the same amount. We have four of the top bearings and five of the bottoms. Well, look inside. So where do you think that's gonna go? Probably on the top, right? Before we mess with the bearings, we're gonna wanna clean these journals out where the bearings are gonna sit. It was at the machine shop. So it has some residue, whether it's oil or whatever, cleaning, whatever. So I'm gonna take a towel, fold that up nice, the alcohol, put some on the rag, and we're gonna just slide it through, just like this. Clean that up in there. You don't want to have anything underneath the bearing once the bearing is installed, because that will cause premature spinning, possibly. It's not likely, but a clean motor is a happy motor. So just remember that. Go ahead and clean these. Clean off the tops where the girdle's going to sit, because you don't want debris in between the block and the girdle. That could cause it to crack if it's big enough. Probably not, but like I said, clean motor is a happy motor. Then we're gonna come over here to the bearings. And same thing. We're just gonna grab a bearing and clean the underside of it. And we're gonna clean the inside. Now at this point I just realized I don't have gloves on. So I'm gonna put some gloves on just in case you catch anything in the fingers. And gloves the first line, you know. Don't want any metal slivers, they suck, they hurt real bad. And you also don't want to get debris in the motor from what you have on your hands. So I got gloves on, and clean this one again. Then immediately going to put it into the motor. Push it in. So I put that one in, and that's what it looks like when it's installed. The light is out of control in here. It's very bright, perfect for building motors, terrible for taking video. So I'm gonna go ahead and clean another one real quick and show you the install. I'll wipe it back off real good. Wipe the inside out. Okay, get your bearing. Come over here. Try and hold this thing. Usually I use two hands. So you notice when you drop it in, oh my god, it doesn't fit, right? It doesn't fit. You gotta push it in. So I usually push down in the center. Some have little tabs. There's a different method of putting them in when they have little tabs. But you wanna push it in so it's flat on both sides with your finger. As close as you can get it. So like I said, you can see now that oil hole, you can see. You can see the oil holes over there. It's going to supply the crank, the journals with oil. And this one's covered up. It's just so they're flip-flop. You can flip and flop them. There's no left or right. There's no up or down. Well, there is up or down. So, excuse that. But you can, like I said, you can flip them either way. Okay, so I'm going to clean the rest of them real quick. Clean it back. Cleanliness is your friend. Just remember that when assembling a motor. Put that right in the motor. Engine, for some of you guys that are gonna hate, oh, a motor's electric. Yeah, I know, I get it. But it's just what I've called it forever. When I build an engine, it sounds weird to me. When I build a motor, it sounds better. I don't know, it's just one of those weird things that I have. Also, when you are putting this together, it's terrible
to see. You want to inspect the bearing surface to make sure there's no imperfections. There's not any imperfections. I'd show you. Thank God. That's a good thing. No imperfections. All right. So we're going to clean our thrust washer now, our thrust bearing. Like I said, a million names for everything. Clean this up. Remember to clean the back. Okay. There you have it. Now we're going to put this guy in. So now you can tell on a normal main cap, there's no cutout here, right? And this, there's a cutout. Let's do the math, right? Okay, some thrust washers are in the back, some are in the middle, some are on the third, some are on the fourth. They're all different. So you're just gonna install this just like a normal bearing. Push it in, make sure it's flush. You're all happy. Okay, so that's the top bearings. Like I said, I'll describe these when we get the crank in there. So I went ahead and I took care of the griddle already. The smooth bearings in the bottom and the griddle side. Now there's no thrust washer on here. The center is bigger, so you will notice it as well. So there you go. I did that, cleaned them all, put them all in. So it's just, I felt it was pretty tedious to record it all. Here we have the crank. So we're gonna clean these journals. These are the main journals. These are the rod journals, main journal. This is for a balance shaft that we no longer have in the motor. Rod journal, main journal, rod journal, main journal, rod journal, main journal. Trend, huh? And then there's counterweights. But if you do have a balance shaft, you don't need this. This is called a balance shaft elite. Some people use this nice piece and they buy. I just tap this hole, put a plug in it. So you can buy this nice little kit. It's an extra $35. It's not really worth it to me when I can tap it and plug it. So we're gonna clean these journals in here with some alcohol. Dirty. So clean motor is happy motor. Remember. Graphite Moly lube. It's made by CRC. I personally like this stuff the best. It offers protection from when the bearings first spin. It's durable and it won't wear, you know, it offers the added protection. So as oil might just wear away real fast and you'll hot spot the bearing. Shorten the life of it and possibly end the life of it on first startup. You don't want to do that. So we're just coating the bearings, putting a little bit on my finger. You don't want to go crazy. Don't go crazy. If you go crazy, you may actually have premature failure. I have seen motors where people put too much on and it actually spins bearings. Don't want spun bearings. It's no good. It's a bad motor. In case, I'm sure a lot of you know that. So we're just gonna do that. Put it on the surfaces. Real nice thin coating. I mean, not thin, I guess. I don't know, but moderate. Moderate's a good word for that. So you can see, just a moderate coating. Nothing crazy. I like it. Used it all my life when I put my cranks and my rods on. Then we're gonna take our crank. We're gonna drop it right in. It's a heavy son of a bitch for being a four cylinder. Right. Drop it right in. Okay. So now, thrust washer. What the hell is a thrust washer and a thrust bearing? You can see it in the middle there. So I'm going to move the crank back and forth. Either you can audibly hear it or see it, the crank moving back and forth. That's called end play. I'm not going to go into detail really and bore you guys to death on a video on how to build a motor about freaking end play. Basically, it takes the thrust of the crank and allows it to move, and there's a bearing surface there. Look it up. I don't want to bore you to death. It's a very important part. So, I'm going to take the girdle. I'm going to install some lube on it. Actually, before we install that girdle, this motor is getting main studs, not bolts. So I installed them first. They are dirty. So I'm gonna go clean them real quick. I will see you guys in 1 second. Okay, so we have our main studs we're gonna put in. You have the Allen key side and the non-Allen key side. Two different thread pitches. Well, it looks like it anyways, kind of. Maybe not on the mains, but I know for sure on the head studs. But anyways, you have a long side, a short side. Short side has an Allen key. That's where the nut goes. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna put in the main stud by hand. Okay. Thread that all the way down. Doop da doop da doo. Okay, bottomed out by hand, okay? So what I do is I take a ratchet, and I make sure it's all the way down. I tighten it just a little bit. I mean, we're talking 5 foot-pounds. And then I loosen it, okay? And then I bring it back in with hand tight, okay? So the reason you do that is to make sure you don't have any debris in the threads. And also, I see a lot of people, they torque these to like 8 or 10 foot-pounds. That's not right. It's not correct. That's not what ARP wants or calls for. So the best way I can explain it is a stud clamps both ways. It's the tension is across 2 different sets of threads in the block and on the nut on top. That's why studs are more desirable than bolts, because bolts clamp down and the only stress is on the bottom set of threads. It's not bad. Bolts are not bad. Don't get me wrong. Studs are more desirable for higher horsepower and more stress on the mains. As well as the heads. Like I said, you put these in dry, nothing on them, nothing. And you put them in finger tight. That is exactly what ARP wants. Do not do anything else. Do not do it, because you have a chance of cracking your block. So please do not do that. So, put the rest of them in real quick. got all your studs in there. Now you're going to take your girdle. And the way you can tell it's the front of the girdle. These are for your rear main. These two holes right here. Bink, bink. These two holes, bink, bink, are for the oil chain guide. So that's why I know it's the front. And we're going to carefully slide it over all the stuff. Drop right down. Okay. Give it a nice little push. Not going to go anywhere. As you can see, y'all have a split there, right there. You know, it's not flush. Oh no. Well, when you put your nuts on and you tighten them, it will bring it down. Okay? So we're going to go ahead and do that. It's gloves on because we're going to get dirty. Okay. So, if you don't have a nice fancy jar like me, and you're just a one-time builder, and you don't have a jar of this ARP Ultra Torque Lube, the studs will come with a little pack, and enough to do what you want to do. Grab our washers first. Now you want to generously apply this. Okay, so here it is. Pretty gross stuff. It smells real bad. So what I do is I just paint them all up. Paint them all on your hand here. Get them nice and lubed. And the reason you want to lube the washers is because if you don't, that metal starts to gall up from the washer to the girdle. It will be an improper torque. And you're going to feel, once you torque the nuts, they're going to pull a little bit. It's going to feel really kind of weird, a little bit of a weird sensation. And that is actually the lube, torque lube, doing its job. If that makes sense. So you're not galling the metal together to create that torque. You're actually nice and lubed, creating that torque. So we're gonna grab our nuts as well. What I do with these is I take my stick here and I just stick it inside and give it a little bit of goopy in there. And spin it out by hand, and if it feels metal to metal, you need some more lube in there. It should be a nice smooth twist. Should feel nice and easy. I'm gonna do the rest real quick. Now, the factory main bolts are what are called torque to yield. So you will do a certain foot pound and then a certain degree of angle. These are not torque to yield bolts, so we are going to go just foot pounds. Now we're going to go to 60 foot-pounds on these main nuts for our studs, but we don't want to attack it all at once. We don't want to go right to 60. So what I do is I do three increments of 20. So I'll go 20, 40, 60. We start in the center. Boom, boom. I don't know what Mazda actually recommends. I do This one. So you start in the center and work your way out. And that's to prevent warpage, so you don't have a bubble in the middle. You start pushing it down and you work the bubbles out. That's the way I've always been taught to do it. And I do believe that's what Mazda wants. So I'm gonna go ahead and torque these real quick. Sorry about that. I had a little bit of technical difficulty. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna go 20, 60, 20, 40, 60. Torqued up. You're gonna want to make sure the crank spins freely by hand. There's nowhere to really grab it, but you can see it spins nice and free. There you go. Perfect. So crank spins. Good thing. Got locked up. So I'm gonna end the video there for today. The camera battery seems to be shitting out. So there's that for now. We'll do rods and pistons. Obviously it doesn't really matter for you guys. It's been to be a few seconds, but it's gonna be a different day. I don't know what's wrong with the battery. I think it's just not charged. So I'm gonna let it charge overnight. So yeah. That is how you put a crank in. And I'll pick it up here in a few seconds.